Hi VSDC family! In this video, we will show you how to track moving objects and apply 5 of our favorite effects. We'll demonstrate how to pixelate a face, overlay a funny image, blur a moving object, change colors in your footage, and even remove an unwanted element entirely. Let's get started! Pixelation. First, add your video to the timeline. Right-click on it and choose Create Movement Map. Give your map a name, click Save and frame the face with a bit of extra space. Click Start Analysis. Click Apply Editing to save the map. Next, create a duplicate of your video, open the top layer and add the pixelize effect. In the Properties window, set its cell size to 10 pixels. Draw an ellipse over the face. Change its brush color to black and set the composition mode to inverted mask. Double-click the ellipse, go to the Add Object property, and select the movement map you saved. Finally, to smooth the edges, add a Gaussian blur to the shape, set blur levels to 20, and enable Extend the Boundaries. Check out the result! Your unwanted detail is now neatly pixelated. Overlaying with an image. Who doesn't love a good laugh? For the second skater, we'll replace his face with a fun picture. All you need is a PNG file and your video. Create a new movement map for another object in your video and add a meme image above the video. Stretch it on the timeline, resize it on the scene, and double-click the image to add the saved movement map. Adjust the meme's position as needed. To make the movement smoother, click on the map on the timeline and navigate to the Convert to Curve option in the Properties window. Choose the settings you like or follow our example. Well done! Blurring a face. In this example, we'll blur the face of the third skater. Duplicate your video. Create a movement map. You may notice that the process stops if the object leaves the frame, so try switching the tracking algorithm to DCF-CSR. Perfect! Save your map. To the upper video, add a Gaussian blur effect with blur level set to 20. Then draw a black ellipse over the face and switch its blending mode to inverted mask. Copy the Gaussian blur effect, go inside the ellipse and paste it there too. Just make sure Extend the Boundaries is enabled. Finally, add the movement map you saved and adjust the ellipse position if needed. That's it! Changing colors. Our next trick involves changing the color of the left skater's clothes. Once again, duplicate your video and use the free shape to outline the skater. Leave in a bit of extra space. Set the brush color to black and the composition mode to inverted mask. Add the latest movement map inside the free shape and adjust it so that it matches the skater's position. Then apply a Gaussian blur effect with Extend the Boundaries enabled and set blur levels to around 100. This way, the skater is isolated from the background. If you want to learn more about isolation of objects, please watch the video using the link in the upper right corner. Now let's add the color grading effect. To change the clothing color, we'll use the LUT editor. Create a new LUT by clicking the check mark and selecting Create LUT. Increase the points to 8x8. Use the Pick Color tool, hover over the clothing, and watch where the color appears in the LUT editor field. Move those points towards your desired hue, say bright green. Adjust as needed until you love the result. It's simple, yet visually impressive. To fully color the t-shirt, move the face blurred video inside the video with color grading and place it below this effect on the timeline. Removing an object. Finally, let's remove the parachutist in the sky. Duplicate the video and create a new movement map for the parachutist. Open the video, add the newly saved map, and smooth it out using Convert to Curve. Draw an ellipse in the sky near the parachutist, set the brush color to black and the composition mode to inverted mask. And add a Gaussian blur above the ellipse object. Then copy it and paste to the ellipse, ensuring the Extend the Boundaries option is on. Then go to Scene 0 and shift the video so it covers the parachutist. And voila! You've replaced them with another part of the footage that follows the same motion path. And that is all for now. We hope these examples help you in your own projects. See you next time!